Sometimes when you're using Google Sheets, you want the formulas that you're using to be aware of today's date or today's date and time or sometime relative to that. All right. So if you close a sheet, look at it again tomorrow, it's going to update with that day's date. So we're going to go over two functions right now that are going to allow you to do that. The first one is the today function, which just gives you the value of today's date, and now function, which will be the date and the time. So first, let's talk about what that means. So if I come into here and I type today, and you do an opening and a closing parentheses with nothing ever in the middle of them, you need those parentheses just because all the functions in Google Sheets need parentheses, so they want to keep that format. So you close it off and hit enter, and it just returns the value of the current day, puts it in the cell. So being used on its own, it's really simple, and you might think, why would I ever do that, right? But we'll go through some examples that'll make it a little bit more obvious about the different things that you can do with it. But let's just do one little tweak now. So we'll do today again. So this is what we just did. But let's say you want yesterday, or you want tomorrow, you want last week. An easy way to do that is just say, if you want yesterday, just do -1. Right? So that just ticks it back one. So that might start to give you some ideas of how you could use this. As I go through these, if you want to get links to these spreadsheets, and you can go to File and then just make a copy and put it into your own Google Drive, go to sheetshelp.com/today or /now, depending on which worksheet you want, or doing both. Scroll down to the bottom, there'll be a link down there to the spreadsheet. But let's go to the next function, which is now, and we'll just show you a simple example again. If you do now, it returns the date and the time. So what that means underneath, if I were to change that date into just plain number formatting, it would be an integer, which is what would specify the day, but then that time is going to add decimals to the end of it because it's really just a fraction of a day. All right, so keep that in mind also as we go through these. You can do the same thing. You can increment this by a day, or you could do something like you can increment it by an hour. Okay. And you would do that by saying, you would add 1/24 to it. All right. So that makes it 1900 hours instead of 1800 hours. All right. So let's go back to the today function. We'll look at the first, kind of a real world application of it. And let's say that we wanted to do some inventory aging. So you have the purchase date here. So we're saying we're looking at finished goods. Maybe you have a warehouse where you keep these before you sell them. Yeah, but some of these are getting old, right? So we want to see how old they are. We're going to combine the today function with something called the year frac function. Year frac meaning the fraction of a year. All right, so we'll say year frac. And it wants the start date. So we'll say that's when we purchased it. So that's when it starts to age. And then the end date, we'll just use today. All right, so we'll still do the opening and the closing parentheses. We'll close that off, hit enter, and this is telling you it's 6.6 years old. Okay, so that's really handy, right? Keep in mind, when you close this worksheet, or even when you just reload it or enter another formula, this result will update. Now you won't be able to tell because it doesn't have a time on it unless you just happen to do it right after midnight. But this is always recalculated. So if you look at this tomorrow, these values will be different. So the application of now and today, you want to use it when you want a dynamic spreadsheet, when the changes are desired. So we'll paste this again, and it's just showing you doing the same thing on these subsequent rows because you have a lot of inventory. If you don't like all these decimal points on here, and the year frac function does that, you can either just change the formatting by going to format number and choosing something here with less decimal points, or you could use the round function. So you would prepend, an example of it here, prepend the word round to these other functions, and you specify how you want it to be rounded. I'm guessing you don't want all of these decimals, but it is accurate, so it's right. So you may want it that way. And then we'll look at another example that uses the current date and time and how you might want to do that. So we'll go back to the now function. Remember, you can get your own copy of this if you want. And we'll say, we're just going to say you keep a log of when you do something during the day. In this example, we just use when you feed your chickens. I think I was feeling funny when I made this. Although farming's not funny. It's a good job. And let's say you want to calculate when you need to feed them again, right? So you need to figure out how long it's been since you've done that. What we would do here is just come up with the current time right now and then subtract when you did it last. So you kind of get the duration between the two periods of time. So we'll start out with now. So what time is it right now? And then we'll subtract when they were fed last. And to get that, kind of as we discussed before, the date is an integer with the fraction added onto it. So we will just add that fraction for the time, hit enter. And it's saying it's been 10 hours, 8 minutes, and 15 seconds. Now be careful here, this is not an AM or a PM, so this is a duration and not a time. When you go up to format and you go to number, you see how duration is checked? So time has an AM or a PM on it. Duration is still hours, minutes, seconds, but it's a time from one point in time to another. All right, and two more examples of combining this with another function. So we'll just put these both on the screen at the same time. Let's say we wanted to return a date that's 6 months from today. All right, so what day is 6 months in the future? What you want to do, you can use a function called edate. And edate takes a starting date and then goes forward or backward however many months that you specify. So we'll use a now function in this case, but we'll talk about why this would be the same as a today function. We'll say 6 months from today. We'll do that and it works. It's March 28th, 2023. But be careful using the now function in another date function because now puts the time on the end of it. But then these date functions strip the time away. So you can either use the today function, which doesn't bother with the time, or just change the formatting to this, but know that that's going to truncate the time off of it. And if that's not what you want, then you will have to do this function another way. But this is a way to increment the date 6 months forward. You can go backwards too. I could come in here and make this -3, and that's June 28th, 2022. So you can go both ways. And the next thing that we can do is we can, let's just say we want to return, let's find out the last day of the month. So if you forget how many days September has in it, or maybe you need the number of days in a month for whatever other calculation you're doing, the function's called eomonth, so end of month. The start date, let's use today this time. Although if you use now, it'd be the same thing. It would chop the time off the end, so be aware of that. And let's say the last day of the month. So this month, so we're not, this function can move backward and forward, but in this case, we're just going to say zero. So this month, hit enter, and it tells you that there's 30 days in September. Let me change that formatting. Now, when we did the inventory aging, we returned the value as a fraction. Well, you can return the value between two dates as the number of years, the number of months, or the number of days. And you can kind of make a sentence out of it. You can say this piece of inventory is 7 years old, 3 days. I'll show you how to do that next in this video about the DATEDIF function. I'll see you in that video. Thanks for watching.